Sports presents a tremendous night of boxing live featuring that man, Larry Holmes. Holmes, unbeaten in 31 outings, holder of the WBC version of the heavyweight championship. His opponent, that man, Earnie Shavers. Remember the demolition of Kenny Norton in the very first round when those two met? So, it is Larry Holmes against Earnie Shavers, and at stake, the WBC version of the heavyweight championship, scheduled 15 rounder. Live from the Sports Pavilion at Caesars Palace in Las Vegas, Nevada, the WBC World Heavyweight Championship. Undefeated Larry Holmes against the number one contender, Earnie Shavers. This ABC Sports Special is brought to you by Anheuser-Busch Natural Light. When you want a smooth, clean taste in a great light beer, just say natural. And by American Motors, makers of quality products, Spirit, Pacer, Concord, the famous CJs, Cherokees, trucks, Wagoneers, and the new Eagle with automatic four-wheel drive. All right, there's Larry Holmes in his dressing room, and he appears as confident as ever. Maybe he's emulating too much Muhammad Ali. Some feel that way about it. Under any circumstances, he seems to be in the best boxing shape of his life. And so, we want to take you to the boxing history of Larry Holmes. In the early part of his career, he was in and out, showed no real talent, and then suddenly he erupted. Let's pick up at the point where it became clear that Larry Holmes was a quality heavyweight fighter. This was when Larry Holmes catapulted into prominence, gave notice he might be a quality heavyweight. You saw the Shavers right in the second. He survived it, worked out of trouble by round 12 in total command. He had rendered Shavers helpless. Only Shavers' courage kept him upright. But for Holmes, an easy and overwhelming victory, and suddenly some people knew about Larry Holmes. They certainly knew about him. After June 9, 1978, the war against Kenny Norton, the WBC version of the heavyweight crown at stake. Norton fought gallantly, but Holmes maybe even more gallantly, and so Holmes acquired the crown that day. The 15th round, one of the most memorable in contemporary boxing history, Holmes the winner. The first defense came in November in Las Vegas against Alfredo Evangelista, a lopsided affair. And in the seventh round, Evangelista went. And then there was the troublesome Puerto Rican with the awkward style, Ozzy Ocasio. Holmes proving he could adjust to style, floored him four times, finished him in the seventh. But as his image had grown, so suddenly was it hurt. This against Mike Weaver in the Garden in New York. And this was the 10th round, and Weaver was hurting Holmes, who seemed sluggish and unable to put his punches together. And so he was struggling. In round 12, though, Holmes came back, and he began to pummel Mike Weaver. And it was at this point in time that the official felt Weaver was helpless, Holmes the winner. And so Holmes, because of the Weaver fight, has some new questions to be answered. Questions that should be answered tonight against Earnie Shavers. All right, once again, Larry Holmes, who just watched that boxing history in his dressing room. And as I said, he seems to be in the best boxing shape of his life. In the meantime, his opponent tonight seems to be the reborn fighter he claims to be. And there are a lot of people around here who think that Shavers may indeed take apart Larry Holmes this time. He's using a left jab that he didn't have when he fought him the last time around. Everybody knows, of course, that Earnie is a devastating puncher. But everybody knows in perfect fact that Earnie has had an up and down career. Oh, he could knock out Jimmy Ellis in the first round. Take a fearful pummeling from Ron Lyle and himself be done away with. But always he would come back, as he did against Henry Clark in the second round, and struggle to an important victory over Roy Williams. And there was a night in his life more important than any other night, because unlike Rodney Dangerfield, Earnie Shavers got respect. So in his boxing history, let's go back to that night in his life. As one looks back, it wasn't that long ago, really. Earnie Shavers. Shavers got his title chance 2 years ago, almost to the day. In the early going, he batted Ali, but failed to take advantage. Ali won the decision. Shavers got respect. But against Larry Holmes, the most doleful performance of Shavers' career. Holmes completely dominating for an easy win. And then there was this night, the incredible victory over Kenny Norton, with Earnie Shavers proving he is still the most devastating puncher in the business. Listen, Norton showing no movement at all. Whatever his strategy, he's paying a price for it. In this, the very best, Norton down quickly. We told you that many liked Shavers' chances in this fight. It's got a low as he in deep, deep trouble. You just saw the legs rubbery as he fell against the ropes. The first knockdown. Scored in the... There goes Norton again. This time I don't know if he can get up. It's stopped. Bill Blaine has stopped the fight. It was a tremendous evening for Earnie Shavers, a reborn fighter in his own mind with a manager he cares about. And so tonight he gets another title shot. And so back to Earnie Shavers in his dressing room. His manager now, Frankie Lucan. His prior manager, Blackie Gennaro. Shavers outspoken about his distaste for Gennaro and about how much he cares about Frankie Lucan. Holmes has been training for 6 weeks here in Las Vegas. Some think that has to take something out of you. Shavers has been training up in the mountains. How do the two men behave when they are together with an interrogator between them? Well, we hit that subject when I sat between them earlier and talked with both of them. Each has definite views as to how he will fight the fight and about the other man's ability. Let's look. Earnie, I think we have to begin with you. The burden clearly is on you. March 25th, a year ago, Larry decisively outpointed you. Why should it be different this time around?
Well, Howard, you know, I got rid of my old manager. Got rid of the headache I had. I'm properly trained now with good people. I had plenty of time to prepare for the fight. Last time, we was off 5.5 months. We had 4.5 weeks to get ready. And you know, we had the money allocated this time, and we're in good shape. We have good sparring partners. Had 9 weeks in training camp, same we had for Norton. And it will be a completely different fight. You'll see the real me fight this time.
How are you going to make the fight?
Well, I'm going to put a lot of pressure on Larry. I'm going to throw combinations to the body, slow him down. Once I slow him down, I'll go to work on him. I take him out.
When will you take him out?
Well, I can't see the fight going over 5 rounds myself, Howard. We train for 15, but I just can't see the guy going over 5. Some body shots will take your toll. You know, I'm definitely going to catch him. I'm going to cut the ring off on him, put a lot of pressure on him, make him fight.
How have you improved since a year ago?
Well, my mind's...
Apart from Blackie Gennaro, the ex-manager.
I'm throwing more combinations. I'm working to the body. I'm thinking now. Before I was walking right in, trying to pin on the right hand and take the guy out.
Well, the viewers are going to be watching you. What about the left jab?
Well, I can get away from the left jab. I'm using that now. I can slip
now,
inside.
What about your jab?
Oh, my jab, I got a good jab, very strong jab, Howard. And I think once I hit Larry a few times with that, it won't stay out of the way, too. I'm going to be using it a lot more than I used to have.
Larry. You heard Earnie say exactly how he was going to fight the fight. You do come off what for you was an embarrassment. You know that, against Mike Weaver. Well, I felt that you lost some confidence after that fight the last time we talked. Is there truth to that?
No, I didn't lose any confidence. I got smarter. I worked harder, you know. I learned a lesson from that fight. I learned not to take people lightly. I was going so good, so strong, how I was beating up everybody, 31 fights, beating Earnie Shavers, beating Kenny Norton, had Earnie out 3 to 4 times, you know? And I figured nobody in the world could beat me. And everybody was saying this guy couldn't fight. The newspapers were saying he couldn't. The TV networks didn't want him. And I said, what the hell? I shouldn't even have to train for this guy. And I found out different. You have to prepare yourself for everybody and go back to the drawing board and do the things that you know how to do.
Will you be fighting Earnie the same way you fought the first time? Circular movement, lateral movement, the rapier-like left?
I don't think so, Howard. I think I'll be right there in front of him. I think I'm going to make him fight. Earnie haven't been really pushed. I mean, I've been going back all the time, letting the man come forward, which that's my best fighting plan. But Earnie got, like he said, I got a little dog in me. Earnie is known to have dog in him. Jerry Corey took him out in one round. Ron Stanton knocked him out. Ron Lau knocked him out. Bob Sterling beat him. And the other 55 guys he knocked out, we never heard of.
Most of them same guys he fought, Howard.
I never heard of them.
So you feel...
Can ignore it.
So you feel you're back to where you were.
Yes, Howard. I think I'm better now than where I were because since the time that I beat Earnie Shavers, I have won the title. I have beaten Kenny Norton. I have defended my title 3 times, and I matured with another year of age. And I feel that by winning the title, that gave me more confidence, gave me more to fight for.
Let me ask you a very direct question. I've watched you with the fans around here making speeches. Are you muddling your own mind by trying to be too much like Muhammad Ali?
No, I want to be like Larry Holmes because Howard isn't only one Ali. Ali did his thing and now I'm doing mine. Ali was a legend. If I can be as great, as good, as flamboyant as Ali was, great, let me do it. Because I feel that he was a great man, he was a legend in his time, and if I want to set an example, let that example be a good one. Just like you, Howard, you're good in your thing, I'm good in mine. And if we're not good, they're going to replace us. And this is why we have to be good at what we do.
Final 2 quick questions. You're going to stay out in front of Earnie. You're not going to move the way you did in the first
I don't really know how much I'm going to move, but I never ran from Earnie, and I'm not going to run from him this time.
Isn't that asking for disaster?
No, because he don't punch. He hit me before, Howard, and you seen it, and all the people all over the world watched it on ABC, ABC seen it, and he didn't hurt me.
I hope tonight he stay in front of me. We'll see if I can punch.
Okay.
We'll all go home early.
Well, a final question. Earnie says you'll go in 5. What do you say?
That's probably when he'll go. Okay.
Good luck to you.
Thank you.
Good luck to you.
Thank you, Howard.
You're both good men.
Thank you, Howard.
I'm better window, Howard. I'm the champion.
Howard. A man afraid to do a lot of talking.
I talk because it gives me, I got something to say. That's why I talk.
Now, let's take a look at Earnie Shavers. They're bringing him in now from the dressing room. He's been shadow boxing. You have seen him just a few moments ago. And you see the perspiration over him. He doesn't want to come into the ring cold. He told us that, too, in our talks with him. There, graphically, is the ring record of Earnie Shavers, 58-7-1. And then there is Larry Holmes. Holmes boasts that he has never come into the ring cold. And his body, now being greased up, looks to be superbly trim. In fact, Larry weighed in at 210 pounds. Earnie weighed in at 211. And incidentally, as we watch Larry being rubbed down and go back again, a glimpse of the packed house in the sports pavilion. Don't forget, tomorrow, NCAA college football. Penn State against Nebraska, the key regional, and the others speak for themselves on that graphic there. Miami of Ohio, incidentally, the team that only lost to powerhouse Michigan State in the final minute last week. They are good. And, of course, the nationally televised game. The powerhouse offense of Ohio State, but the now questionable defense against UCLA, which seems to make a habit of beating Big Ten teams. Well, we'll find out about that. Again, the scene in Caesar's Palace's sports pavilion. Earnie Shavers with his retinue just past Lloyd Wells, who used to be part of Ali's retinue, was once a key scout for the Kansas City Chiefs. But that's Earnie Shavers into the ring now. Moving corner to corner, on his toes, past the color guard in ring center. And Earnie Shavis, who vows and declares that this time he will annex the title. He had a shot at it with Ali. He gets a shot at the WBC version for the second time. And he seems to have the look of a confident fighter. So with the Holmes-Shavis fight coming up, we'll be right back. We're back live in Las Vegas, Nevada. Larry Holmes may be trying to psych out Earnie Shavis. He is still in his dressing room. Shavis already in the ring. And Shavis with a huge following here. Make no mistake about it. Indeed, a large contingent of people from Warren, Ohio, which is adjacent to Ernie's hometown. Earnie Shavis. And look at Holmes. Patiently taking his time, looking up at the television monitor right now as this reporter talks. And I've just been handed a series of sayings by Frank Luca, the manager of Earnie Shavis. Says here in front of me, dreams can come true. And then, interestingly, there's a quotation of a man named Garson Kanin, the brilliant screenwriter, playwright, director, sometime producer, Garson Kanin, who wrote a book, and this is what it was. It takes a long time to become young. And so Frank Luca has been doing his homework, his reading. Meantime, again, the crowd in the arena. And don't forget, live from Lambeau Field in Green Bay, Wisconsin at 9:00 Eastern Time, ABC's Monday Night Football, the talent-laden New England Patriots against the Green Bay Packers of Bart Starr. You know about the Pats, Steve Grogan, Harold Jackson, Russ Francis. They've got the players. The pack may have memories, but there is something there. Holmes is really holding up Shavis. The tactic now seems utterly obvious. Freddie Brown just walking around in there, serving in the corner of Holmes. Shavis doesn't seem to be letting it affect him as he engages in badinage with some of the fans and waves to them. But we've seen this tactic tried before. George Foreman tried it on Muhammad Ali in Zaire. Remember, it didn't work for George. I don't know if it'll work for Larry, but that much seems clear. Going back to my interview with both fighters, remember the way it was in the first fight as Holmes begins now to leave his dressing room to come out. Holmes using that constancy of movement, withstanding a savage right that landed in the second round, jabbing his way out of trouble with the jab and with movement, went on to an overwhelmingly easy decision. I myself thought at the time that would be the end for Earnie. Instead, it was another beginning. And there, coming down with the WBC Championship belt being carried above his head and in front of him is the defending champion, Larry Holmes. Well, at 35 or 36 or whatever he is really, Shavis has to know that this time it is it. There can be no further comebacks should he lose. Total crossroads fight for him this time, for real. And for Holmes, the desire to prove himself all over again after Mike Weaver. All right, we're now on the verge, finally, of this WBC Heavyweight Championship fight. We'll be back in a moment. Superstar appearing here right now, and a fight fan. And all over the world with that lady, her opening in London, her opening in Paris. Always she goes, and there he is, the Yankee Clipper, the man who looks better with every passing year. He's here with another guy. They have the best looking white hair in the world, the two of them. They've grown gray beautifully. And the man I'm talking about, you're about to see. There he is, Cary Grant. Once he was Archie Leach, a stilt walker at Coney Island. He became one of the greatest stars in the history of motion pictures. We're back to Earnie Shavers. I tell you, it's worth it to get old if you can look like DiMaggio and Grant, Chris.
Why, don't you? I'll tell you one thing. Davy Pearl is the referee of the scheduled 15-round championship bout, and I would think that he'd rub off some of the grease on the body and face of Larry Holmes. We'll see if he does.
What was your honest opinion of Holmes's tactic?
I thought it was Bush. You know, you don't, you're the champion, and I don't think you keep a man like this waiting. But they did. And you talked about a set of pipes. Marvin Gaye is in the ring, Howard, to sing our national anthem. Tremendous talent.
And a very sad man because he owns Andy Price, whom Leonard destroyed. Here is Marvin Gaye with the anthem. To allow our local stations to identify themselves. That's Earnie Shavers, and in this jam-packed house, many of the fans were just on their feet chanting, "Earnie, Earnie, Earnie, Earnie." You have to like him, you have to respect him. A great deal of hardship in his life. But now, this one last chance that we talked about before and kept waiting in the ring. And I respect your candor, Chris. I respect it a very great deal when you said you thought Larry's behavior, there is Holmes right there, was Bush.
Well, it's unlike a young man that I really care a great deal about. We've known him a long time, Howard, and I just think he was ill-advised.
All right, let's go to Chuck Hull, the ring announcer, for the introduction of the fighters.
Ladies and gentlemen, the judges assigned by the Nevada State Athletic Commission for the next bout are Harold Buck, Lou Tabbitt, and Hal Miller. The referee is Dave Pearl. This is the main event of the evening. 15 rounds of boxing for the World Boxing Council Heavyweight Championship. Introducing In the blue corner, fighting out of Warren, Ohio, weighing 213 pounds, the challenger, Earnie Shaver. And in the red corner, fighting out of Easton, Pennsylvania, weighing 210 pounds, he is undefeated in his professional career, the champion, the Eastern Assassin, Larry Holmes. 15 rounds of boxing.
All right, there were the introductions by Chuck Hull. Quickly, 10-point must system, mandatory 8-count, no standing 8-count, no knockdown limit. 3 knockdowns in a round does not automatically terminate the fight. Fighter cannot be saved by the bell except in the final round. The three judges, Harold Buck, Lou Talbot, and Hal Miller, scoring the fight. The referee is Dave Pearl. And, of course, in Holmes' corner, where there has been some friction and some unsettlement, Rich Giacchetti, the manager trainer, the cut man, Freddie Brown, and in the corner, there's Giacchetti, who just saw him, the bell for round one. Keith Clever is also in Holmes' corner. The doctor who made his arm well again and apparently made pitcher Frank Tanana's arm well again. First round action. And let's watch and see how much Larry Holmes moves. Shaver's wanting to cut off the ring. Nail Holmes quickly, the way he did Kenny Norton. But Kenny's battle plan played right into Norton's hands, into Shaver's hands. This is first round action. A rapier left. A critical weapon for Holmes. Holmes now delivers the right with much more authority than he used to. The body following through better with getting the power of the body into the arm. It used to be just a swish. First round. They're in ring center. So far, Larry has not been moving the way he did in the first fight. When quickly, there you saw a touch of it, now back. Lateral movement was his weapon as much as anything in the first fight, March 25th, a year ago. 3 quick lifts by Larry Holmes. Holmes, tall, big man, great reach. But Earnie's reach, almost as long. Not that much by way of reach advantage. Now, if there's improvement in Earnie, who tried to go to the belly there with the right, it would have to be in the delivery of the left jab. It used to be nothing. Now it appears he's been improved. In his corner, of course, Frank Luca, Audie Dorr, Ed Hayes. Now you've got the nuts and bolts of it. We're into the final minute of round one. You saw Holmes dance out of trouble. He had thrown a right, and he didn't want to leave himself open to Shavers. So he quickly moved out of trouble, which you must do when you're fighting Earnie Shavers. Oh, Holmes, very clever. Very clever there. Had Shavers off balance when he hit him with the right. Holmes wanting to reestablish himself in the minds of so many after the relatively lackluster showing against Mike Weaver. And Holmes boxing well in this first round as we approach the end of it. Round two. We are coming to you live from ringside in Las Vegas, Nevada. Second round, Holmes against Shavers. Holmes is back to you. Shavers is such a strong man. But Holmes quickly with that left jab. Wants to make it a repeat of the first fight. When he was an easy winner by decision. Shavers winds up for his punches. Oh, Frank Luca claims, oh, not the way he used to. There was that left jab. And this man is so strong that when he touches you, you wake all over. One thing is clear, this was no Kenny Norton fight plan against Davis. Holmes knows what he's about. He's got great hand speed for a heavyweight and excellent foot speed. See that left jab? So far, it's the dominant blow in the fight. On Ascot Card, Holmes won the first round without too much trouble. Jabbing away with that leg. A couple of them getting through Ernie's gloves.
In the corners, Ernie! In the corners!
Ernie, as of old, looking for the opening to destroy the opponent with a one punch. This is a one punch knockout fighter, Chris.
Yes, and Holmes with a classic strategy of jab and move, jab and move. That's an impressive, menacing left jab.
Well, his movement off those ropes and away from Chavis in the first round was an evidence that he's got his battle plan. Look at that left, again and again and again. Doubling, tripling on it, and then back with another. And then moving quickly out of danger. That's the second time he's done that beautifully tonight. Holmes is fighting at this point, beautiful at this point. You see the countdown for round two. Lower right hand corner of your screen. Holmes winning the second round with relative ease. Oh, that was the right. That hurt Holmes. It got in right under the chin. We're back live, Las Vegas. Round three just underway. Round two, a replica of their first fight. Chavis landed a right that hurt Holmes in the first fight. Earnie jabbed and danced out of trouble. Here, just before the second round ended, Chavis reached Holmes with a right, hurt him. Chavis getting instructions from Frank Luca between the rounds, telling Earnie he must throw that right more and must get more into it. Said you're not bringing your body through behind that right. 45 seconds into round three. That left constantly troubling Chavis. No matter how he keeps those gloves up there, to look at that. Measuring Chavis with his left, point. Remember when Ali did that to Sonny Liston? Harry Holmes. Minute 15 into round three. Earnie bobbing and weaving, looking for the opening, coming close. Once or twice, but not yet finding it. Holmes, 30. Chavis, a listed 35. The man who would, one would think would have to win early would be Chavis. The stamina would seem to belong to the younger man, and he has proved that stamina, especially in his classic war against Kenny Norton. We have a minute left in the third round. The pattern of the fight, the same. But Larry Holmes left, working over Earnie Chavis. Holmes not moving as much, though you see the movement there as he did in the first fight. Chavis trying to get that right into the belly. Believe me, he has simply stunning power. Remember in the interview, Chavis said he would go to the belly. There's a left. right fist.
Oh.
Right there.
Lovely.
I'll tell you. Shave his hips, and immediately the opponent is hurt. And you can see it happen to Holmes. Round four, live from Las Vegas, Nevada. Holmes against Shavers. And if there's a difference from the first fight thus far, it would be that Holmes is not moving nearly as much. He may pay for that because he was stunned in that third round by Shavers. There is that good Holmes left, though, and there you saw him double up on that rapier-like jab. That's some fast jab for a heavyweight to have, especially one as big as Larry. You just saw him throw it three times in a row, two connected. Now Holmes moving to the left, back to the right, back and forth, not providing a target, which is the way to fight Earnie Shavers. Make one mistake and you can go in a hurry. Earnie wild and missing with a right. Don't forget, we're in the fourth round. Each fighter predicted the fifth round in that interview you saw earlier. Staying away from Shavers after scoring with the left jab. The pattern seemingly redundant now. And very much in the manner of the first fight. But you never know. See, Earnie keeps the gloves up, but Holmes's left gets good. A good combination. And Earnie laughing about it, but he felt it. A left by Holmes, and then a right uppercut. And yet Holmes staying out of danger. That's the movement. Now tying up Shavers. David Pearl trying to break them apart. Larry Holmes fighting his fight. Holmes again with a good left. Shavers desperately wanting to tag him. Holmes suddenly with a right lead that got in there. And you saw the measure, and you saw a good right uppercut by Larry. It was the right uppercut that floored Weaver in the 11th round of Holmes's last fight in New York in June. There's the right lead again, another right. And suddenly, Holmes is adopting a new weapon, the right lead. And Holmes is making this fight his way thus far. We're back live, round five. Earnie Shavers suffered a cut in the corner of the left eye that was repaired between rounds. And Frank Lucas said to him, you've got to jab more, and you've got to throw the right more. But so far, Holmes has made the fight. Set the pace, fighting his kind of fight, using the left, and then unveiling in the latter part of the fourth round, a tremendous series of rights, three of them right leads. Fifth round action, a round when Earnie said he would knock out Larry Holmes. And Larry Holmes said he would knock out Earnie Shavers. Now Shavers trying to get down to the belly to reach Holmes and weaken him. But you see Holmes with that movement staying away. He'll go back to that left jab now to reset the pace. See, there he goes. Use the left. Set up the right. Earnie not yet able to get to Larry Holmes. Right there. Shavers landed a right. And Larry Holmes feels. And the left got to Holmes. I tell you, you can't measure the power of Earnie Shavers. It is devastating. Unquestionably the best puncher alive. so you must always be careful. Davis getting the right into the belt. So, not looping, swinging wildly, looking for the head of the knockout. There, Holmes came back with a serve. There's the right lead again. Another right lead. Then the left again. Scoring still with many more punches than Earnie. Right there. What Holmes must remember is to be careful. If he does that and fights this kind of fight, should be no problem. His skills are great, and he is young. Counting down to the end of round five. This was the round when Earnie landed a couple of good ones. I thought that would bring a warning from referee Burr. The end of the round at hand. Back live, start of the sixth round. Earnie Shaver's left eye, very red, appears to be in bad shape. Frank Lucas said to referee Dave Burrell, he thumbed him in the eye, and what did you do about it? Dave Burrell said, knock it off. He never thumbed him, he hit him. Just a little bit of the byplay as with the sixth round gets underway. No question that so far Holmes is fighting his kind of fight. Right there, a strong Shaver's punch against the right side of Holmes, and Holmes moving away as you saw. Believe me, that punch hurt him. Sixth round action. Holmes back to the left, on his toes. Enough movement to stay out of range, and with his reach, make that left jab work as he just did twice. And the right. That right goes into that left eye, and that left went to that eye. And Earnie doesn't seem to know what to do about Holmes, about the left, about the right lead, about the steady movement. The left. Same story. Shaver's getting into the midriff there. Once, twice. Larry tying him up. Oh. A minute left in this, the sixth round. Wild right that missed. Another wild right that missed. Throwing and missing that way takes something out of him. Now the other eye appears cut. The other eye of Shaver's. He's in deep trouble. And Shaver's was stunned by that Holmes right. Shaver's was hurt. Look at the right eye now. Blood streaming down over it. Shaver's in deep trouble now in the sixth round as Larry Holmes comes back to the kind of form he had prior to the Mike Weaver bout. 15 seconds, counting down, round six. Big round for Larry Holmes. Holmes totally dominating the fight. We will go to Earnie's corner as this round ends. There's Shaver's, and you better know he knows.
Huh? Yeah, you're shoving the thing in too far. That one, Eddie, that one.
Try to pick up some of that natural sound.
You gotta keep your hands up. You're getting through with the cuts. You gotta keep your hands up, you hear? Deep breath. Hands up, Ernie. Cut him off in the corners. In the corners.
That's Frank.
In the corners, baby.
Frank Luka talking to him. You heard him say, keep the hands up. He's getting to you with the cuts. Keep the hands up, Earnie. Now, by way of contrast,
come on, baby.
Larry Holmes.
Keep that jab in his face. Just go now. Come on now.
Can the little face then jab you?
That's right.
Holmes looking so fresh by contrast. You heard Cicchetti and Freddie Brown. Keep that jab going. He can't hit you. A lot of blood on Holmes's trousers. Trunks, not trousers. But the blood is the blood of Earnie Shavers. As Larry goes right to work and reopens the cut over the right arm instantly. Pecking away with that jab. This is the seventh round. We are live from Las Vegas, Nevada. Out of the right eye of Earnie Shavers. A terrible thing to see as Holmes is relentless in the use of that jab and occasionally the right, as you saw that. Shavers fighting half blindly now, trying to get in. Holmes dancing out of trouble. The right was one of those long Shavers powerhouse fights. Shavers has been following Holmes ever since. Holmes moving. This is why you can't ever count Earnie Shavers out. Holmes, the right's a little bit wobbly. Now Holmes isn't able to move off of those ropes, which is where Shavers wants him. We have a minute left or thereabouts in this, the seventh round, and Holmes was really hurt by that Shavers right. Shavers with the right into the midsection. Holmes seems to be coming to himself now, but he... hold together. Earnie Shavers at age 35 or whatever, with 10 seconds left now in the round. Holmes defenseless, taking it from Shavers. Holmes, the end of the round here. What noise, what a turn of events. Round 8, live from Las Vegas. Earnie Shavers with the first knockdown of the fight. Holmes had dropped his left. Shavers came over it with the long right. And Holmes was ready to go. But he somehow lasted the round. Let's see how he will hold together now. A half-fine Shavers was being boxed apart by Larry Holmes, who had things all his own way the first 6 rounds and was having them his own way in the 7th. Both of Shavers' eyes cut, and then suddenly the one mistake, and a puncher like Shavers can kill you with that one mistake. So we are in the 8th round, and Holmes is back to his pattern. He's moving, he seems well enough. The blood again pouring down from Holmes' right eye, from Shavers' right eye, correction, and the Holmes left getting in there again and again. But now, all eyes are focused on that Shavers right as Holmes runs. And do you blame him after what he got in the last round? We'll have a station break at the end of this round so the 2 stations can be alerted for it down the line. This is the 8th round, and this fight has become something. Get your hands up, Earnie! last round. Holmes now fighting back. Make no mistake. Once they said Larry Holmes didn't have courage. They said it about him in the Olympic trials against Wayne Bobbitt. He has shown his courage. He showed it five times over. A good right by Holmes in the fight against Kenny Norton that went the distance. Each fighter said the other has dog in it. I can't believe they meant it. I don't see any dog in either man. Holmes, knowing he must keep moving, he must keep moving from Holmes's point of view. Earnie, now in trouble himself again. It's gone back the other way. But the wild right. Holmes failing to take advantage of Chavis when he was off balance. Holmes, tired. But Holmes having himself a big round after the knockdown. We'll return with more boxing action after this from our local station.
Dead tired and losing his cool.
Holmes. That's the way Earnie Chavis' left eye looks. It's all but shut. He is fighting half blind, as I said. Holmes appeared dead tired at the end of round eight, but he came back big from the sudden knockdown in round seven. Holmes showing his gameness. Chavis, nobody could fight a gamer fight than he is fighting. Right, the right hurt him. Chavis is hurt. He's against the ropes. He's defenseless now, or half so, or so it seems. A wild swing by Chavis. Hard for him to see the opponent. This has turned into a brawl. The six rounds of boxing lesson delivered by Holmes. The seventh, the Holmes left dropped. The Chavis right nailed him. Down went Holmes. The only knockdown in the fight. But look at Holmes. There's the right. Again, doesn't Holmes look tired to you? A little bit wavering, a little bit wobbly. It seemed to me that at the very end of the last round, though, Holmes had a big comeback round. He was about to lose his cool. Right there, he showed his cool. Scoring with a combination. There. These two fighters are exhausted now. And Earnie Chavis talking to Holmes, trying to taunt him. But Earnie Chavis with the left eye virtually closed, the right eye not bleeding at the moment, but bleeding throughout the fight. Earnie just keeping the hands up there, hoping that somehow he will get the right in. We're a minute 45 into the ninth round. Just hoping, that's what Chavis is doing, that the right will connect. He was this way, appeared this done in his fight against Roy Williams, Chavis was. But then suddenly, at the very end, he bailed it out. Holmes, scoring with the blow. Low, good uppercut. Chavis hurt again against the ropes. Earnie trying to fight back, but Earnie now himself ready to go down. How much more? There's a wild right. Left himself wide open. He is just blinded. He's now taking it. Look at that right and that right and that right and the uppercut, the right and the left uppercut. And Holmes is mercilessly laying the blows upon him. But Earnie, as he staggers there, head going down. No movement by referee.
Holmes coming back
there, right there. Chavis incredibly start with the right, and it was Holmes who went down. He got careless.
He ruled it. Him.
And so, Chavis, this is just incredible.
He ruled that no knockdown.
Round 10, and I have just talked with referee Dave Pearl, who said because there was no mandatory eight count, we had to ask him. He said, I ruled that a slip. The blow was on the shoulder. I ruled it a slip, not a knockdown for Earnie Chavis. Well, he's got a right to rule it. He's in there.
But Howard, there is a mandatory eight count on all knockdowns.
I understand that. He called that knockdown right. A slip. That's what I'm saying.
That's...
We're in the 10th round. This crowd responding to the courage of Earnie Chavis. Did you see him in the 9th round? And now he's taking it again. His body was bent over in two, and yet he did not go to the canvas. Look at that uppercut. Holmes continues to win the fight up to this point, but always there is the danger of what happened in the 7th round, where there was, by the referee's precepts, a clean knockdown. Earnie got in a left. You have to keep watching for every blow Earnie throws. They are few and far between now, but if they can connect, Ernie's doing the talking, as you saw. Both fighters exhausted. Both of them. Look at that. That's not professional fighting, but there is nothing left but the heart. And Holmes half falling over himself from fatigue. This is the way it was with Norton and Holmes when they were both exhausted at the end. And there is Earnie, just trying to land that right. He landed one. They are both so tired. Holmes just looked down at his corner for an instruction. Holmes back with a flurry. How he does it, I don't know. We're almost at the end of round 10. Now, what is he doing here? I don't understand what referee Dave Pearl is doing. It looked like he was going to stop the fight. Back comes Chavis, but he didn't. I will talk to him between rounds again. We're back live. Referee Dave Pearl, apparently totally confused, halted the action in the waning seconds of round 10 because he said he thought the bell had rung. There was still about 18 seconds to go. There's Holmes with the right off Chavis. 11th round action coming to you live from Las Vegas, Nevada. And both fighters exhausted. We have had one official knockdown. It occurred in the 7th round. It came from nowhere. Chavis executed it against Holmes. A long, hard right over Holmes' left, which had dropped. Seemed to have repaired the cut over Ernie's right eye, or over the corner of it, but the left eye remains virtually shut. Chavis' corner said, stay with him, stay with him. If you land one, he's gone. Look at that, though. Earnie bent over almost in two. Defenseless, his hands at his side. Tremendous fight. In terms of a brawl, not in terms of skills anymore. Excitement engendered by the courage of Earnie. Look at him smiling as he takes blow upon blow. We're a minute 45 into the 11th round.
Howard, it's like Ali said, he's a tough acorn to crack.
He really is. Look at that right. against the left side of his face. Dave Pearl, the referee, checking with Earnie, trying to find out if he knows where he's at. That's it. It's stopped by Dave Pearl. It's an 11th round technical knockout. Larry Holmes, the winner, and still the champion, but he almost lost it. He almost lost it to the courage and right hand of a man who's listed as 35. There'll be no more times around for Earnie Shavers. Oh, maybe he'll fight again, but there'll be no more championship chances. So it ends for him. But it ends for him in a very gallant way. And it ends for him with, as you look at Holmes, his arms upraised. It ends for Earnie Shavers with the crowd standing and cheering his courage. And so it has been done again, and Holmes is the winner. We'll be back at ringside in a moment. So we are back live at Caesar's Palace in the Sports Pavilion. The crowd is still here. No one has left. They realize that a boxing lesson turned suddenly into a brawl, that it happened in the seventh round. They realize that Earnie Shavers doesn't have the greatest of skills. Clearly, Holmes has the better skills. He is a boxer. He can move. Earnie can't. But they love the man's courage, and they love the power of his punch and the excitement he brought to this arena when it happened in the seventh round. In the meantime, in the ninth round, there was that mix-up where the referee called it a slip. There is Earnie, depressed, understandably so. The great dream now over. And here comes Larry Holmes down now to talk with us. A tired Larry Holmes.
2 minutes of the 11th round. Davey Pearl, the referee, stops the bout. The winner, and still,
2 minutes.
The official announcement. As you continue to look at Earnie Shavers. And what a disappointment for that man. But what a triumph for Larry Holmes. And here is Larry Holmes with me now, the camera to turn upon us. I want to tell you one thing, my friend. We're still waiting for the camera to come down on us. We've also been joined by Rich Giacchetti. And it was, well, it was, as I said, in the end of brawl. There we are on that camera, Larry.
Lisa, I love you. I'm all right. I'm a bad champion.
I'll tell you one thing that you men both proved. There's not a bit of dog in either one of you.
Yes, it is, Howard. Doberman. Remember I told you that? All Doberman. Knock me down, I'll come back.
Give Shavers credit. He did catch in that seventh round. You know that.
Howard, I talk a lot. I try to sell myself as a champion. I feel that I have proved myself over 32 fights. Earnie Shavers would knock all of them out. The hard puncher, Earnie Shavers. Only thing about it, I can absorb the punishment. And I feel that I'll be champion for a long time. I'm still going to give all the heavyweights a chance to get something that I didn't get to. That was the shot at the heavyweight champion. I proved myself out. I'm tired of proving it.
Okay. What I wondered about, Larry, was you talked about Shavers as a hard puncher. His punches next to yours in number were few and far between. But did he hurt you earlier, before the seventh round? I saw a blow in the second. I saw another in the fourth. I felt you might have been stung.
He hit me hard enough to make me realize it, that he can punch. And I feel sorry for all the heavyweights that Earnie Shavers fight because he's gout and he proved himself as a boxer, a puncher, and he can go the distance. It's just that I was hitting so far, so much, it took a lot out of him. I cannot discredit Earnie Shavers or any boxer who gets in the ring with me. As you know, I worked very hard for Earnie, and if I didn't work as hard as I did, Earnie Shavers would be the heavyweight champion of the world.
Right. All right, I want to show the viewers once again round seven, I'd like you to talk over at the time when he floored you out of nowhere because you had given him a boxing lesson in the early rounds.
Oh, Lord.
So let's take a look at it now. Go ahead, Larry.
See, I was so confident, and that's just to show you can't keep building of confidence with a puncher like that. But I'm a boxer, and this man is slick. I watch the films, and He just waited, and I'm waiting for him to throw that overhand right over the over my left, which he does. That's why I try to lean to my left quite as much as I can, lean to my right, because he's strong. And I don't care what John Tate and all them other fighters do. Ernie Shavers will take them all. I don't care what they say. And I just proved to you again how I'm the baddest heavyweight in the world. Got up from a puncher and whoop him.
Right there, he got that right over your left. And you were getting careless with your left, as you said, beginning to drop it.
Confidence, Howard. And that's just to show you, you got to go in there with all fights.
Hold on 1 second, Larry. Earnie! We're going to be talking to Earnie right after we finish this. Ernie's coming right over. But you pick up, Larry.
Ernie's a strong fighter, and I don't care what he says. He wear a man down, he take him out, he hit him. I just blessed by God that I am chosen to represent all people throughout the world as a heavyweight champion. I was able to resolve this man's punishment because he's one hell of a puncher. And I feel that everybody that's watching this on ABC knows it. Earnie Shavers will always fight and represent any network in the world as a worthy contender because he is a champion in his own right. And I don't care what nobody says, he's the number one contender in the world.
All right. We're looking, of course, at action.
Right hand, hit me with. See that?
Yep.
But I proved again that I can take it.
This was round seven.
Bam. Nope, that wasn't it, huh? Hit me with an overhand right.
You'll say it. I hope.
Well, ABC don't miss nothing.
That's very kind.
I'm just proud that ABC has represented me.
There it was.
Right hand. See
you
that?
See that, Richie? Overhand. Right over the left. A perfectly thrown right.
Because he didn't double jab. When he didn't double jab at time, Earnie countered him with an overhand right. He had a double jab and pushed him back, and he never got hit with the punch.
That, of course, the voice of manager Rich Jacchetti of the still WBC heavyweight champion Larry Holmes. Larry, you were in deep trouble here.
I'm telling you the truth. I'm telling you how, but I know that I was fighting for the world, for the people, to prove myself as a champion, a people's champion. And I want to say, Howard, I want to thank you for giving me the opportunity to say nice things about me. Also, I want to thank Jim Spence for being a hell of a director. He's one hell of a guy, and all the ABC crew, because I love him. And hi, Mom, I'm fine. And hi to my Miss D and Lisa, my daughters, because I love them.
Okay, good luck to you, and congratulations on the victory.
Thank you. I
love Take
you.
Care, Rich.
And I love you, Earnie.
All right, why don't you stay here and say hello to Earnie, and we'll be back to talk with Earnie Shavers and Larry Holmes in just a minute. We're coming to you live from ringside in Las Vegas, Nevada. We're back live ringside Las Vegas, Nevada. Water being poured all over Larry Holmes and all over me and all over Rich Jacchetti. And here is the gallant Earnie Shavers. Question number one. Did you think you knocked him down when referee Pearl ruled it a slip in the ninth round, the second apparent knockdown?
Yeah, Howard, I thought I knocked him down. But I guess it was a slip. The referee said it was a slip, but I thought I was knocked down myself.
Now, were you upset by Larry staying in his dressing room late at the start of the fight?
Well, that didn't bother me too much. No, you know, I was okay. I guess he's the champ. He wanted to try to let me get cold or burn myself out moving, but, you know, that's part of the trick of the trade.
Will you agree that there's no dog in either of you? You put up a great scrap.
Well, yeah, I think Larry put a great fight up. I got thumbed in the third round. I couldn't see him that well. Not taking nothing away from Larry. He's a good fighter, but I did get thumbed twice in the third. And I was blurry. I couldn't really see Larry that clear.
I knew you could.
But,
I'll tell you this. You won the hearts of a lot of people in this arena, and I'm sure millions around the country. Because you're a gallant man.
Well, Howard, Larry haven't seen the last of me. I'll be back. Give me 6 months. I'll be back.
Somehow I almost believe it. You've done it so many times before.
Believe
but
me,
that's
be
your decision and Frank Luca. And you can feel proud too, Frank. You did a fine job.
He fought a great fight. It's the first time anybody put Holmes on his back. And I told him he would deck him, and he did. And I feel that he had him down twice. But Larry won the fight, and Earnie will be back.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, and thank you, Earnie. And even in defeat, our congratulations to you. As the two men shake hands. It's been an extraordinary evening. We said we thought with this card we would have dynamite action. We did. Quickly, let's review the whole evening. Wilfredo Gomez in a very tough fight, unexpectedly tough, TKO'd Carlos Mendoza in the 10th round. Sugar Ray Leonard with an absolutely awesome performance, brilliant, put away Andy Hawk Price in 252 of the first round. A puffy Roberto Sluggish Duran won a unanimous decision over Zeffy Gonzalez. And then this WBC Heavyweight Championship belt with Larry Holmes, the TKO winner in the 11th round. We think that it was a fine night of boxing. We think boxing fans deserve it. They've been waiting too long for this kind of action. But we got it tonight. From Las Vegas, Nevada, for Chris Schenkel and myself, so long from ringside. Once again, Larry Holmes has successfully defended his WBC World Heavyweight title with an 11th round TKO of Earnie Shavers. Be sure to join us tomorrow for NCAA college football doubleheader at 12:30 Eastern Time. Top regional games highlighted by Penn State at Nebraska, followed at 4 Eastern Time by Ohio State against UCLA. Check your local listings for the game in your area. The executive producer of ABC Sports is Rune Arledge. Coverage of tonight's fights produced by Chet Forty, directed by Joe Assetti. Technical director Bill Morris. Associate producer Alex Wallow. Associate director John DeLeese. The WBC World Heavyweight Championship fight was brought to you by Michelob Light. It's simply a matter of good taste. And by the American Eagle, a new family compact with automatic four-wheel drive. Travel arrangements made through. Promotional fee paid by you. United Airlines. United is building the largest airline in the world around you. This has been a presentation of the leader, ABC Sports, bringing you exclusive coverage when the world comes to America for the 1980 Winter Olympics. So long.